Welcome to the kitchen of Ardgillan Castle. This is a typical early 1800s, early Victorian kitchen insofar as it was meant purely for the preparation and cooking of food. So no running water in here, I'm afraid. The room that you've just come through is the room through which everything that would have been served upstairs on the table would have arrived here into the kitchen for preparation. The range to our left is early 1900s. It's state of the art. Maguire and Son of Dublin were the builders. It's again perfect engineering functions, controlled by flues and also controlled by dampers. First thing in the morning, a young servant girl would have lit the fire, and it was her task to make sure that when the cook came on station that the fire was lighting perfectly. On one side you have a box for baking and on the other side for roasting. To the left of the range then you have what's called a hot plate. If the range was allowed to die down in the evening after the cooking functions had been completed, the hot plate was kept going 24/7, and that was perfect for slow cooking or for if bread was being prepared with the yeast in it for raising the dough. This is one of the few items of furniture left in Ardgillan since the time of the tailors, and as you can see from the way it's constructed, it was built in around the beam, and therefore we know that this is custom made for Ardgillan. When the furniture was being sold, it was impossible to sell something like this because it couldn't be placed anywhere else. This is again a prime example of a dresser, but again very early, because the open part at the bottom has no doors or drawers, and that indicates its age. Dressers typically in country cottages would have been built by journeymen carpenters, but this obviously was made by artisans, and you can see from the embellishments and the wood carving that this is indeed a very prime piece of furniture. The table that you're looking at is a perfect example of the type of table that would have been here, and the poor servants, unlike the guests who were in the dining room directly upstairs, the servants here would have had their meals without the comfort of chairs. They only had benches. They never used chairs in kitchens. Two reasons. One, they didn't want servants becoming too comfortable, and number two, you could always squeeze an extra servant onto a bench. The area over here, then directly under the window, was used primarily for baking, and again you can see directly outside the window a passageway which the servants would have used as they were moving around the house. Unfortunately for the servants, they were not normally allowed at ground level, so access to all parts of the castle was through a passageway. This area over here was where all the preparation for baking took place, and you can see the slate top is still here, and unusually a breadboard with carving of words on it, our daily bread, not normally seen. Everything else here belongs to the period. Further along on the counter we have the butter churn, and we have the butter pats, and we have again most unusually a number of butter seals. Through this door, this is where the water was. Initially you can see the stone sink. The tap that's on top of it went in much later, probably in the late 1800s. Initially, when the sink was put in, it was laid very low so that young girls who were doing the washing up would be able to lean over into it. However, they didn't use the sink for washing, they would bring in buckets of hot water, so everything got washed in buckets of water, sometimes basins of water on the floor. The usual age for starting work in a house like this would have been maybe 9, 10, 11, and it was at the sink that a lot of girls started working. Of course, through the open door, they were able to see into the kitchen where the cook was busy or where the pastry cook was working, and their aspiration was to, as soon as they could, get out of there and go work in the kitchen proper where it was much warmer. Unfortunately, there are tales in houses like these of where when young kitchen maids didn't carry out all their duties properly, that they were consigned to another part of the house as a punishment, and that was the laundry. But that's a different part of the house.